In 2293, while returning home after a successful mission cataloging gaseous planetary anomalies in the Beta Quadrant, the USS Excelsior, under the command of Captain Hikaru Sulu, was struck by a subspace shockwave. Initial investigation revealed the shockwave resulted from the destruction of Praxis, a Klingon moon utilized for energy production. With only fragments of the moon remaining, the destruction of Praxis threatened Klingon, eating away at their ozone layer, leading to the total loss of oxygen over the ensuing 50 years. Surely the destruction of a moon is a violent and serious thing, enough that it forced an end to decades-long hostilities and a tenuous peace between two warring races. But could a moon really be destroyed? And if so, would it lead to the imminent demise of the parent planet? For nearly the entire 4.5 billion year history of our solar system, the Earth hasn't been alone while we revolve around the Sun. Our giant lunar companion is larger and more massive than any other moon when compared to the planet it orbits. When it's in its full phase, it brightly illuminates the night, and the moon has been linked throughout history to phenomena such as insanity, or lunacy, animal behavior, howling at the moon, farming, a harvest moon, and even women's menstrual cycles. While those links don't stand up to scientific scrutiny, there are many ways the moon actually does affect the Earth. Destroying it would be a catastrophe, but would also change our world forever in some incredibly interesting ways. Destroying the moon would send debris to Earth, but it might not be life exterminating. Imagine a weapon so deadly it could gravitationally unbind the moon, blowing it apart. It would take a medium-sized asteroid's worth of antimatter to do it, about a kilometer in diameter, and the debris would spread out in all directions. If the blast were weak enough, the debris would reform into one or more new moons. If it were too strong, there would be nothing left, of just the right magnitude, and it would create a ringed system around Earth. Over time, those lunar fragments would deorbit thanks to Earth's atmosphere, creating a series of impacts. But these impacts wouldn't be as destructive as the asteroids or comets we're so afraid of today. Even though chunks of moon would be massive, dense, and even potentially larger than the asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs, they would have a lot less energy. Asteroids or comets striking Earth move at 20, 50, or even over 100 kilometers per second. But lunar debris would be moving at a mere 8 kilometers per s, and would strike only a glancing blow with our atmosphere. The debris striking Earth would still be destructive, but would impact our world with less than 1%, the total energy of a comparably sized asteroid. If the chunks hitting us were small enough, humanity could easily survive. The night sky would be naturally much brighter. Once the moon and all its remnants were gone, the second brightest object from Earth's sky would be completely gone. While the Sun is naturally 400,000 times brighter than even the full perigee moon, the full moon is again 14,000 times brighter than the next brightest object in the sky, Venus. When you look at the Bortle dark sky scale, a full moon can take you from a 1 inch, the most pristine, naturally dark sky possible, all the way up to a 7 or 8, washing out even bright stars. Without a moon, there would be no natural impediments to pristine dark skies every night of the year. Eclipses would be no more. Whether you're talking solar eclipses, partial, total, or annular, or lunar eclipses where Earth's natural satellite passes into our shadow, we would no longer have eclipses of any type. Eclipses require three objects to be aligned: the Sun, a planet, and a planet's moon. When the moon passes between the Sun and a planet, a shadow can be cast on the planet's surface, total eclipse. The moon can transit across the Sun's surface, annular eclipse, or it can obscure just a fraction of the Sun's light, partial eclipse. But without a moon at all, none of these could occur. Our only natural satellite would never pass into Earth's shadow if it didn't exist, putting an end to eclipses. The length of a day would remain constant. You might not think about it much, but the moon exerts a tiny frictional force on the spinning Earth, causing our rotation rate to slow down over time. We might only lose a second here or there over many centuries, but it adds up over time. Our 24-hour day was only 22 hours back when dinosaurs roamed the Earth, and was under 10 hours a few billion years ago. In another 4 million years, we won't need leap days any longer in our calendar, as the rotation rate slows and the length of a day continues to get longer. But without a moon, all that would cease. It would be 24-hour days every single day to come until the sun itself ran out of fuel and died. Our tides would be tiny. High tide and low tide presents an interesting, vast difference for those of us who live near the coast, particularly if we're in a bay, sound, inlet, or other area where water pools. Our tides on Earth are primarily due to the moon, with the sun contributing only a small fraction of the tides we see today. During full moons and new moons, when the sun, Earth, and moon are aligned, we have spring tides, the largest differences between high and low tide possible. When they're at right angles, during a half moon, we have neap tides, the smallest such differences. Spring tides are twice as large as neap tides, but without our moon, the tides would always be the same paltry size and only a quarter as big as today's spring tides. Our axial tilt would be unstable. This is an unfortunate one. Earth spins on its axis, tilted at 23.4 degrees with respect to our orbital plane around the sun. This is known as our obliquity. You might not think the moon has much to do with that, but over tens of thousands of years, that tilt changes, from as little as 22.1 degrees to as much as 24.5 degrees. The moon is a stabilizing force, as worlds without big moons, like Mars, see their axial tilt change by 10 times as much over time. On Earth, without a moon, it's estimated that our tilt would possibly even exceed 45 degrees at times, making us a world that spun on our sides. Poles wouldn't always be cold. The equator might not always be warm. Without our moon to stabilize us, ice ages would preferentially hit different parts of our world every few thousand years. We would no longer have our stepping stone to the rest of the universe. As far as we can tell, humanity is the only species ever to willfully put ourselves on the surface of another world. Part of why we were able to do that, from 1969 to 1972, is because of how close the moon is to Earth. At only 380,000 kilometers away, a conventional rocket can make the journey in approximately 3 days, and a round-trip signal at the speed of light takes only 2.5 seconds. The next closest options, Mars or Venus, take months to get there via rocket, over a year for a round-trip, and many minutes for a round-trip communication. Has the moon ever been at risk of being destroyed? The moon has never been at risk of being destroyed, at least as far as we know and based on current evidence. The moon has withstood plenty of impacts, all whilst holding strong. The moon has been around for some time. During that time, plenty of objects, like asteroids, for example, will have crashed into it. But the moon is yet to be destroyed. It takes the impact and carries on. Craters have developed after particularly strong impacts. Humans have also contributed to this as well. Several years ago, a new crater formed on the lunar surface after a piece of space junk collided with it. It was basically a discarded rocket stage that had been floating in space for a while until it finally collided with the moon. The rocket was destroyed, of course, but the moon survived, but for a new crater in its lunar surface. What could destroy the moon? You would need some sort of superweapon that could produce the amount of energy required to destroy the moon. Scientists refer to the amount of energy required to dismantle a gravitationally held object as its binding energy. The binding energy of the moon is 1.2 x 10 circumflex 32 joules. If you can produce a weapon that can summon this amount of energy, then you have a weapon that can destroy the moon. As far as I'm aware, no such weapon is available on the market right now. But I'm sure it's possible one day. After all, it takes approximately 1,800 times more energy to destroy Earth than it does the moon. And right now, it seems like we're getting pretty close to being able to do that. What could produce such a vast amount of energy? Well, it would be the ultimate cosmic betrayal, but the sun could. If you were able to somehow target all of the sun's energy at the moon, our own nightlight would be destroyed within 15 minutes. If you are a supervillain and you're now considering destroying the moon, you might want to chill out for a moment. Destroying the moon would probably send lots of debris crashing back down to Earth. Finally, now you know that the moon isn't just a pretty face. It fulfills plenty of invaluable duties. Destroying it would therefore be a disaster. Thanks for watching. To stay updated on the latest discoveries, make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications.